point. Right? Kind of ridiculous, right? Mr. Hoskins was talking about my having flown here from New York just a few days ago, and boy, are my arms tired,
right?
Sorry. There's always someone who hasn't heard it, so. But anyway, my name is Pete Malinverni. It's really just an honor to be here to rejoin my dear friend and colleague, Brian Hoskins, who I think you probably know is really quite something special. I travel around a lot, and I hear a lot of choirs, and I watch a lot of choir directors, but I don't quite remember ever setting up my phone to record videotape him warming up his choir as I did yesterday, because it's just so brilliant the way he does it. And the love he has for each one of your kids is real. So before I go any further, I just want to publicly ask you to help me thank Brian Hoskins. Yes, sir. So we're going to just play the trio and I. Chris, Devon, and I are going to play a couple of tunes now for you that are from a recent trio CD that is actually due out June 16th, but I have some copies here tonight, and I hope you'll consider taking some home. There are also CDs of The Creation, the piece we're going to put on in the second half of tonight's performance. Just right quick to tell you what the genesis of, that's funny, the genesis of The Creation, right? Where it came from, the inspiration of it was, I have a choir back. I run the jazz studies program at State University of New York in Purchase. And one of the things I do is run, I founded and I run a gospel choir, more or less a gospel choir. It's a choir dedicated to exploring the music of the African American experience. And I got a commission to write a piece, and I wanted to use as my text something from a well-known African American writer who happened to be a man named James Weldon Johnson. And some of you may know his most famous musical piece, which is Lift Every Voice and Sing. His brother wrote the music to it. But anyway, James Weldon was a poet, and he wrote this series of poems called God's Trombones, and one of them is The Creation, and it's basically as told by a preacher of the era, the early 20th century, when Weldon Johnson was writing. And so I set it to music, and boy, Brian has got this choir really just singing their hearts out on it. I can't wait for you to hear that. In the meantime, we're going to offer you a couple of selections. The first thing we're going to play is something written by, really, I think, one of the great American heroes, Duke Ellington. He wrote this tune called Heaven. And then after that, well, I'll tell you what we're going to play anyway. We'll see how this goes.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you. That's actually the title track from my new record, my new trio record, and the whole recording is songs of the spirit. And that doesn't necessarily mean religious in nature, but some are. That one in title certainly called that, as I said, the title track. But here's one that was written by, I'm not sure how many of our audience today remember the great Curtis Mayfield. Right?
Yeah.
Curtis Mayfield. Well, he wrote this fantastic tune called People Get Ready. Right? You remember that? People Get Ready, right? I could go on and on, but I won't. Anyway, so here's our little take on it. We hope you like it. Thank you. Hey, I want to thank you very much. I don't think that I was, I think I've been remiss. Not I think, I know I've been remiss in mentioning a few things. First of all, and I'm thinking about it right now, after that beautiful fun we just had trading fours and eights and stuff, but how about the wonderful Devon Lewis at the drum set? Devon Lewis. So we're here on the first ever performance I've been lucky enough to give alongside Devon on stage, and it's a real pleasure. It's just like meeting somebody and talking to them. Sometimes you just hit it off, right? And that's quite what it's like here. On the other hand, I've gotten to play with our bassist for this evening a whole two times, and he's just wonderful. He felt like a friend the first time I met him. This is Chris Symer. Chris Symer. Hey. And lastly, I want to thank very much the gentleman who's taking care of the sound tonight. It's not easy, and he's doing an amazing job. That's Wes Waddell, also a great musician. Thanks so much. How about this side? Right? Really beautiful. Okay, so we're going to play one more for you, and then we're going to get these beautiful children back up here to knock all their socks off. And the tune we're going to play is something I've liked for a long time. It's the one thing we're going to play that's not from the new recording. But it's something that was written, by Duke Ellington on the occasion of a really cool idea where he and the great tenor saxophonist John Coltrane made a record together. And they both brought their rhythm sections, and they kind of traded off during the course of the record. And John Coltrane and Duke Ellington, it's a great record if you get your hands on it. But Ellington wrote this tune on the occasion, and it's called Take the Coal Train. Take the Coal Train. We hope you like it.
Thank you.
Devon Lewis. Yes, sir. Chris Steiner. Just sure, my name is Pete Malinverni. Thank you so very much. Hold on to your hats, buckle your seatbelts. We're going to have a good time for this next half of the concert. Thanks so much again for being here.
Thank you. tossed him down. And the sun was on his right hand, and the moon was on his left. The stars were clustered about his head, and the earth under his feet. And God walked, and where he trod, his footsteps hollowed the valleys out, and bulged the mountains up.
Thank you.
he said, bring forth, bring forth. And quicker than God could drop his hand, fishes and fowls and beasts and birds swam the rivers and the seas, roamed the forests and the woods, and split the air with their wings. And God said, that's good.
Thank you.
This great God, like a mammy bending over her baby, kneeled down in the dust, toiling over a lump of clay, till he shaped it in his own image.
Thank you so much for being here tonight.